I wanted to see if these aim trainers actually worked, so for 30 days I played one and recorded the results. So I decided to go with Aimlabs mainly because it was free. I know that Kovacs is another one that comes highly recommended, however it costs I think $9 or $10, so I opted to just stick with Aimlabs. Over the course of the month, I spent about 13 hours total practicing on Aimlabs, and that works itself out to about 25 minutes each day. I don't specialize in any particular FPS game. I kind of play all the main ones, so like Valorant, Warzone, and Apex. So I decided to look for a routine that wasn't really tailor-made for a particular game, but just worked on general aim. So this is the routine that I wound up using, and it takes about 15 minutes to complete. I didn't come up with this myself, so shout out to ManAntYagi25 on Reddit. And I'll link the original post of his down below in the description. So on the first day after downloading Aimlabs, it runs you through kind of a tutorial where you do a bunch of different drills and then it gives you an initial score. So my initial score was 386, which put me into gold 2. As you can see on the screen, that score is broken down into 6 different categories, each of which is kind of focused on by different drills and exercises within Aimlabs. After 30 days of doing the routine which I had found on Reddit, I had increased to the ranking of Ruby 3 with a score of 543. So Aimlabs does a really good job of showing you all these different improvement metrics and really breaking down how you do on the drills, but I know that these numbers are kind of arbitrary, so in the background I'll just show some video of me doing the drills on day one versus me doing the drills on the final day of the experiment. And just, you can kind of see the difference in accuracy and speed. And then also if you look at the top, you can see the different scores. And I tried to line up the time so you can compare it if you pause the video. As you can tell from the side-by-side, I definitely improved quite a bit. Other than the pretty obvious increase in speed, I think the biggest improvement was just how smoothly I kind of transitioned from target to target. Before, you can see the movement of the mouse is pretty jerky, and by the end of the 30 days it really smoothed out and I had a lot more control. So overall, aim trainers definitely do work, but I think that you have to keep in mind that it's not the definitive solution to getting good at a video game. Don't get me wrong, I definitely think that my aim has improved and that's definitely translated into when I play games, particularly shooters like Valorant or Apex Legends or Warzone. You have to consider that clicking on circles in Aimlabs, while it definitely improves your mechanics and your kind of muscle memory in your arm and your wrist, it doesn't necessarily prepare you for the different situations you'll encounter within the game itself. I think a good analogy for aim trainers in general is likening it to weight training when practicing for a sport. In the same way that somebody who's very muscular isn't instantly good at something like basketball or soccer, using an aim trainer exclusively without actually playing the game itself will only get you so far. Additionally, the routine I used was pretty basic in general, but if you have a particular game in mind, I'd do some digging around and look for routines more tailor-made for that game, because people have built out different scenarios and situations which better replicate the type of situations that you'll see in a game like Valorant or Apex. So all in all, aim trainers definitely do work, but I think that a lot of people have the misconception that if you just play an aim trainer, you'll instantly become some sort of aim god like Shroud. But the reality is that nothing beats just playing the actual game itself and getting your minutes in there. However, if you are serious about improving at FPS games, I think it's important that you work an aim trainer into your routine. With the main advantage of it being that you can just constantly practice the aim mechanics and developing your muscle memory and motor skills. While in playing an actual game, you're kind of limited by how many times you run into an enemy. Well, hopefully this video was helpful and informative. If you have any questions, feel free to leave a comment down below and I'll try to get to it. Thanks for watching. See ya.